The Region 6 RDC held its statutory meeting yesterday at the RDC boardroom, where several issues were discussed. More details in this Narima Ali report.
The Region 6 RDC held its monthly statutory meeting yesterday at the RDC boardroom in Ryman's Irvine. Several matters of concern were raised by the councillors and addressed by both the chairman and vice chairman. Matters raised included the national strike by teachers attached to the Guyana Teachers Union, the urgency of the National Ophthalmology Hospital, and the need for maintenance of a quantity of canals in the region. Councillor Zamal Hussein delivered his report for the Health Committee and the Education Committee, which the Chairman Mr. David Armagan and Vice Chairman Mr. Dennis Deroop addressed.
Since 3 months ago, I think we were given a commitment for the opening of the National Ophthalmology Hospital. To date, the Public Health Ministry is not successful in doing that. This is 3 years plus, and not a single cataract surgery is being done at this hospital. We have in excess of 2,000 persons backlog.
Unfortunately, all we're hearing is excuses, and tomorrow, and next week. We have heard the director coming here on many occasions. It's either he's misinformed or he lied. Right, because he has come here to say that it's going to be opened in 2 weeks' time. He's come on another occasion to say it's going to be opened next month. So I don't know if he is misinformed or if he is misinforming us. But we have to be able to get accurate statements on what is really the position as to the national. We got doctors sitting there doing nothing, basically.
The time has elapsed so long, about 3 years now, and the teachers have not been given an increase in salary and allowance. That we had close to 500 teachers on strike, which is about 35% of the teachers in the region is on strike. That is on Monday.
So I want to urge that this government take a more responsible approach in dealing with this situation. The minister is saying that the school is not being affected. Only yesterday at Skelton Lang Park, there was only the secretary for the school that present there with 700 and something children. And the minister is saying on her statements in the press that schools are not affected, they have contingency plan in place. This is not so.
The chairman and vice chairman went on to address matters in the agricultural sector of the region.
We're asking that the government move with speed to ensure that these things are cleared and the hurdles are cleared with the U.S. government, so that the captive species that have been presently restricted to go into the United States will be open, so that our fisher folks can continue to make a good living off the fishing industry.
Agriculture project in Oriala, maybe started there. We've set up some coconut plants already. 1,100 went up. We're trying to get another 2,000 for the community, the two communities where we're LSC producer. But we've asked to, for the region to give some support in terms of purchasing some citrus plants from NARI.
Honorable Gobin Harbinger, I look forward to assist the Water Use Association to receive this funding.
I'm in sympathy with the Councillor Harbinger and Councillor Albadu Singh. I don't think he has the capacity to help in any way. So I think we need to raise this matter, because I don't think we will have that amount of money that those. That sum of money, that's an enormous sum of money, is more than 250 canals, additional canals. That will cost us, you know, over $1 billion at least to maintain. So we can't find that money. It's impossible to find it in the budget.
Other matters, such as the need for more school buses on the east bank of Berbice, were also highlighted at this meeting. The chairman is looking into the matter, but is focused on areas like Kanji, where there is dire need since the closure of the estate has a great impact on that district. Narima Ali, Channel 8 News.